Moving now to Helena, where a landmark is up for sale.
Though it's listed at just under $1 million, the price tag might be the least interesting thing about it.
MTN's Jacob Fuhrer shows us tonight.
Step inside this Helena home and prepare to be transported.
All that is original glass from the 1880s.
Inside and out, this home doesn't look much different than it did when it was built.
They started building on this in 1883.
130 years ago, there were no power tools. Every feature, every detail you see, handmade.
All of this in this room is all original woodwork, all handcrafted. No detail was spared back at that time.
In a Helena neighborhood full of historic homes, the Coors Mansion stands out. The Queen Anne home gets its name from Conrad Coors, the famed cattleman credited with the development of the industry in the Treasure State. For current resident Laura Belmer, owning the home was merely a dream, at least at first. Then her wishful thinking became reality.
So this was the first kindergarten.
Upon first walkthrough, the beauty and the history of the home wasn't lost on Laura or her husband.
And we're both like, oh my God, look at this. And I'm like, but you can't help yourself. Every room is just beautiful. And you see more every time you walk into this mansion or every time you walk into another room. You see something that you missed the time before.
For first-time visitors inside the mansion, it tends to elicit the same response each time.
Wow. Everybody that comes here, people I've brought in from out of state and different places that have never been here before, and as I bring them into each room, they're like, wow.
Aside from the stunning craftsmanship and ornate furniture, which there's plenty of, there's also plenty of history in these walls.
Fortunately, a lot of the history here has been documented, from everyday family life to parties to presidential visits.
It's all documented here in this binder that Laura keeps, and there's some familiar names to walk these halls.
Teddy Roosevelt and Coors were both involved in the Montana Stock Growers Association. Roosevelt asked Conrad Coors to introduce him when he was running for president, so that's how close they were.
Roosevelt remarked in a letter once, "Old Con Coors, a fine boy and an old friend of mine, a member of the legislature, and an absolutely honest man." The two were so close, the former president stayed in this very bedroom in Coors' home, but not before it was remodeled to his liking.
And this was originally a closet. They knocked out the wall and then built this bathroom for Teddy Roosevelt when he stayed here.
Belmer said it will be hard to say goodbye to this home. Her hope is the next owner keeps the home in good shape for another 100 years and honors its history.
I think it's very important to keep it consistent, to keep it with the period, and it's beautiful. You can't go wrong.
In Helena, Jacob Fuhrer, MTN News.
Are you looking for a house?
Yeah, can you loan me $1 million? Because
yeah.
That is one nice house.
Beautiful.
By the way, Coors Mansion. Current listing price, $895,000, not even $1 million.
Not a million. Bargain.